morning and we thank God for you. And as we come today in the name of Jesus, we just ask, oh God, that you would bless us in a special kind of a way. We ask, oh God, that a portion of that that you have in heaven, that you would sit down here and that the red carpet might be rolled out in order for the Holy Ghost to walk in. We thank you, Lord, for all that you've done and all that you would have done and all that you will bless on this day. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Reading in your hearing, that is from the book of Psalms. That is the 24th Psalm. And I'm going to start reading at the 6th verse. has been so good to us. And he's not only a great and big, wonderful God, but he's a God that has visited every last one of us. And I'm so glad that when his son hung on the cross, his blood ran down to every house, every person. And I'm so glad that we are here today, that is to celebrate, that is Jesus. We're going to go into our communion service, our short communion service at right now at this particular time. And we're asking those who are ready, amen, that we're going to partake at this particular time. The Bible said on the same night when Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he broke it. And he said, take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. And when the cup, after he had supped, saying, this is the New Testament in my blood. As often as you eat of this, bread and drink of this cup, you do show that the Lord's death, that is till he come. And we do thank God for all of these elements and all of the symbols that God gives us in the Bible. You understand? The bread is his body, and then of course that which we drink is his blood. And I thank God for the blood. For if it had not been for the blood of Jesus Christ, we would not be here. For his blood covers every sin that you have. And I thank God for that. Amen. It's time for us to go to the Lord in prayer. Amen. And we know that there is a lot to pray about. But I must share this with you. About a year ago, our drummer, you understand, his portion of the virus intercepted him and caused him to go, not only just to go through the virus, but he had some rehabilitation. He went to rehab after that. Well, guess what? God blessed him, and he's here today. Let's give God a hand clap. Shemako is here today. And Shemako, we thank God for you. And thank God that how he has blessed you, brought you through, and not only that, but brought you out. And we appreciate that. God is still in the healing business. I don't care what the naysayers say. I don't care what they're saying on sidelines and up in stands and all of that. God is still in the healing business. Amen. We're going to ask Sister Lori to come to you now. That is with the prayer song. And immediately after that, we're going to ask our brother Ted Henry to come and lead us to the throne of grace.
Oh,
praise, and we've gathered in your name. God, we know that in your name, Lord, healing can be done, Lord. And in your name, Lord, deliverance can be done. And God, and in your name, Lord, salvation. So God, we call on the name of Jesus, that name that's above every name, Lord. That, Lord, you begin to move in a mighty way in the midst of your people, Lord. God, in spite of what might be happening on the sidelines, God, we're going to look to you, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Now, God, we'd ask you to continue to bless this word, Lord. Bless our pastor. Lord, he brings the word of life, Lord. That, Lord, someone's life will be changed. Someone will be delivered, Lord. Someone will make a decision, Lord, to live for you. Bless your people, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you just let us see another day, Lord. Not only see another day, but God, you give us activities in our limbs. And God, we praise your name for that. Now, God, we just continue to ask you to move, super move in this place, Lord. Holy Spirit, we give you full reign in this place. Devil, you are a liar and you cannot function in this place. God, we just thank you and we praise you and we bless your name on today. And God, as we go through the rest of this week, Lord, we're going to continue to praise the name of Jesus. For it's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
There's nobody like him, nobody greater. Nobody greater, nobody greater.
Said, I looked, I searched all over. It was a responsible search, but I couldn't find nobody. I was looking to see if I could find somebody greater than you. But guess what? I found out that there's nobody, I don't know anybody that's greater than you. And we thank God this morning that is for that song. Again, I need to reiterate this text, because it's a very, very important text. It says that seventh verse, that our souls is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken and we are escaped. I want to talk, this as long as the Lord will let me, on the subject that says the trap is broken. The trap is broken. Father, we thank you for grace and mercy. Thank you, Lord, for your word. With your word, we can grow, we can develop, we can have knowledge and spiritual knowledge. We move from the natural man to the spiritual man, and the spiritual man has to be fed milk and meat. We ask today, Lord, that we might be fed from your word, or that we might feast off of it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Amen. The trap is broken. Now, a snare, amen, is nothing but a trap for catching, that is the fowls of the air, the birds and wild animals. Amen. And my friend, if you feel like you're trapped, amen, then you are in a very unpleasant situation. That is, if you're trapped, in which you lack freedom and you feel that you cannot escape and you can't get out. Have you ever felt that way? Amen. And one can be trapped, amen, because of a storm and the elements, the flood, snowstorm, you understand. They tell me that a few days ago that Tiger Woods had an accident in his car. And according to the way that they explained it to me, he was trapped. And somebody had to come along and do what? Had to untrap, you understand, or had to free him or loose him, believe it or not. Now, we have met people that have felt that they've been trapped in relationships. Ain't nobody gonna talk to me now. Trapped in the role of being a husband or a wife, amen. But now, marriage was never meant for us to be trapped. Am I right about that? Amen. We're trapped in relationships. We feel like we're trapped in a room and we're locked in a place whereby the entrance door of the lock is jammed, and we're feeling that we are locked in and there is no way of escape. Amen. Trapped because of debt. Some people, they just continually get in debt. They buy anything they see, and they claim they buy anything they want, you understand. But of their own volition, you understand, they have incurred a lot of debt. And we know that we're going to have some debt, and some things that we own, amen, are going to belong to us in the bank, you understand. But you don't have to be in a situation whereby you in debt. That is the rest of your life. Because one day you want to be what? You want to be the lender and never the borrower. Now, here's the question. As we look back over our life, what are some of the snares that God had to rescue you and loose you from? I got some in my life. Y'all can say what you want to. I believe that everybody in this world know what I'm talking about when I'm talking about being trapped. Amen. And right now, at this present time, I feel trapped.
amen, because of the coronavirus, I feel locked down and I feel the consequences of the virus, and there'll be a great sense of joy when somebody says it's all over and you can be set free. I can't get nobody to say amen. We're trapped. You can say what you want. Until God set us free, we are trapped. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? Trap, trap, trap. You understand? Trap. And this psalm, let me talk to you from this psalm, because this is a very, very important psalm. Now, this psalm, amen, it's a sense of, and it has a sense of letting us know that we are in, can be in a situation whereby we need a God to come and set us free. Look what the psalm says. If it had not been for the Lord being on my side, you understand? Look what happened. The enemy would attack us. And not only that, but they would have swallowed us up, you understand? Because people wrote us off. They lied on us, you understand? The enemy would have swallowed us up. But God came along and he set us what? He set us free. We were engulfed by waters. We were engulfed by the flood. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? The current and the present current of the water went all over our bodies. And not only that, but also our souls. But the psalmist say, praise be to God. You see that? Who has what? Amen. You see? Praise be to God. Because the enemy had us in his teeth. This is what the Bible said. And not only that, but he had our souls in a situation whereby the water and everything came over our soul. Amen. Amen. But guess what? We escaped as a bird out of a trap or a snare. You understand? You see, here's the axiom. You understand? The snare of the trap is broken and we escaped. Aren't you so glad you escaped? How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? You see, aren't you so glad you escaped? And our help is in the name of the Lord, he said, who made the heaven and earth. Think about it. What has God helped you get out of? What has God helped you to escape from? You understand? What has God rescued you from? Amen. And as we look at the different metaphors here, as he talk about the beast and the fowls and the fire and the flood and all of that, it reflects on what God has freed us from. I heard a lady say she was in a relationship. She said, I'm so glad to get rid of that big lipped man until I didn't know what to do. I felt her because I've been trapped. If not in a relationship, I know what it is to be trapped. How many of y'all know what I'm saying? You escape some of the things that are so difficult, not only difficult now, but will be difficult in the future. Amen. And this can create a sense of gratitude that is towards God, because you're so glad that God came in the nick of time and he loosed and broke that trap. Amen. And the fact that he's able and he's available to help us when you're trapped in. When you're trapped in. Somebody's trapped in right now. No matter what it is, they're trapped. Trapped into overeating. You can talk what you want. Somebody feel like they are trapped right now. Now, this is a Psalm of David. And David, of course, knew what it was to be trapped. Amen. Because he was chased by King Saul. And King Saul wanted to kill him. And he had a spear. He wanted to pin him to the wall because of his jealousy about David. Amen. Amen. And I'm talking about real life here. How many of y'all know that we're talking about a real enemy? We're talking about real life. We're not talking about something that theoretical or a theoretical idea. Amen. We're not talking about a press conference where you get behind a mic and tell us what happened. But David said, I was trapped in a cave. And the enemy was after me. You understand? But the real focus is not only just on the earthquake all the time and the fires of the air and the animal that's trapped, but now the real focus is on God, God himself. He helps us. He gives us what? Some care. He looses us in the time of trouble. Look at how David began the psalm again. He said, if it had not been for the Lord being on my side. You understand? I'm not talking about your friends. I'm not talking about your confidants. We're not talking about your parents and your prayer partner. If it had not been for God being on my side. And I'm not talking about somebody blessing you with acts of kindness, but I'm talking about God himself coming to the rescue and loosing you from that situation. I wish I had somebody to help me in here. Amen. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? You see, we need this God. The God who said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. The God himself that said, without me, ye can do nothing. Amen. And with the state alone, that is, the Israelites escaped, you remember, from the Egyptian. Not only that, Paul and Silas, they escaped, that is, from the Philippian jail. You understand, as they sung by night, Abraham, amen, he rescued Lot, that is, with the help of God. Noah, know what it is to escape the flood. And then there was Daniel in the lion's den. And we all have felt, amen, where David felt it, as he described as being trapped. You understand? There's something about a trap you need to know. You know some traps? Once they catch you, you cannot move. Amen. Because the more the animal moves, you understand, the trap has a way of ripping away its skin. That's right. When you're trapped, it's very difficult. Sometimes it's hard to breathe, you understand? You see, the animal is trapped. And the animal can't move. You can't move right away because the trap wants you to suffer before you die. And it's a slow, agonizing death. It's a trap. I'm trying to tell you, it's a trap. And some people feel trapped right now. But I thank God, amen, that God not only is the way maker, but he's the trap breaker. Amen. And one of these old days, and my prayer is those bones are going to heal, because I've been trapped and I tried to move and they're broken bones and there's permanent damage that is to our bodies because of the trap, you understand. But see, my soul still yet was set free. Although your body was trapped, but your soul was set free, believe it or not, in the name of Jesus. And you know what? People have a way of setting traps just as they set traps in the old days. Amen. I've known some people, believe it or not, who excel in setting traps for other people. They actually do. That's all they do is set traps. You understand? Not allowing them to be free to speak, not allowing them to be loose and to enjoy their independence. Amen. You see? And then they have what they call a kill trap. A kill trap has a way of doing what? Killing you instantaneously. That's what a kill trap does. It kills you right away. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? You understand? It's a kill trap. You understand? But I don't know about you. You understand? But I know what the devil has come to do. Amen. Let me first of all say I know what a kill trap is, because the enemy tried to kill my joy. He tried to kill, that is, my peace. He tried to kill my sense of somebody-ness, that is, my self-esteem. Amen. If you start a business, he's trying to kill it. You understand? He's first into killing what I call infants, infant marriages, infant baby Christians, infant churches, and infant ministry. Oh, the devil is skilled. Amen. He's skilled in setting traps. And not only that, but he's skilled in killing, that is, the people of God. But I'm just as he is just skilled, if you ask me, that is, in destroying God's people. He's skilled, that is, in setting traps. I know a God that is skilled in setting you free from the traps. I'm so glad that I know the trap breaker. Psalms 91 said that he that dwelleth, that is, in the secret place of the Almighty, shall abide under the shadows of the Most High. Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler. That trap, he's protecting you from the trap. He alone is my refuge in my strength. God is my refuge in my strength, my very present helper in the time of trouble. Somebody said, I've been trapped in the snare, and the devil is holding me. I've been captive, death for the devil. You understand? But the snare is broken. I've been set free. Amen. There's a satanic strap. Trap. There are all kinds. There's a trap of offense. There's a trap of all evil spirits. Amen. But you got to be willing to call on the name of the Lord. You got to be willing to say, God, I'm trapped here right now, but I need to be set free. Well, what are you talking about? I'm talking about some people who've been there for a long time. The trap has broken them, believe it or not. Their bones and their skin. But God came along one day. He said, you don't have to stay here any longer. You don't have to feel the feeling that you feel any longer, but you are set free. And there he loose you. Now you're loose from the fear of tomorrow. He loose you from guilt of the past. He loose you from crack cocaine. He loose you from the white beater. He loose you, believe it or not, from that dull and empty life. Amen. God has set you free from that ditch digger and that trap setter. Amen. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? And I'm so glad that I'm free. I'm free. That is from this world of sin. I've been washed in the blood of Jesus. I've been born again. Hallelujah. I'm free and I'm saved by his power divine. I've been set free. Somebody ought to cry free. You ought to be able to say, he broke the trap. He broke it. And now all the sin and dross is gone. Everything that has been holding me, I've been set free. I'm so glad to be free. Free at last. Free at last. Free at last. Free at last. Thank God Almighty, I'm free at last. The trap has been broken. God is a trap breaker. Says, I'm the way, truth, and the light. Nobody comes unto the Father except by me. God has been so good. For those of you who are out there and you feel like you're trapped, don't let this message go over your head. Say to yourself, I'm shacking up, but I'm getting rid of somebody once I get back home. You got to be set free. You got to get out of that stuff. Get out of it. Ask God to come. Break that trap. Father, we thank you for being a way maker, a trap breaker. We thank you, God, this morning that this message said to somebody, you need to be released. You need to be released. Some of us, we so selfish, we need to be released from ourselves. Really. If we could just be released, we will be different people. Break the chains, Lord. Break the trap. Break the spell. Break that evil spirit that's holding us, God. And we'll thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. As Pastor was preaching, why this song came to me, a secular song actually, but the song says, I only meant to wet my feet, but you pulled me in where the waters run deep. And I know sometimes we get caught up in things that we know we shouldn't be in, but we thank God. He said, I've come to give you life, not only life, but that more abundantly. Shall we be agreed in prayer? Father, we thank you that we can hear a word that will encourage us on today. Know that there's traps that's being set out there, Lord, for us, Lord, to come to. But God, we thank you that, Lord, you are a trap breaker. Lord, if we just come and call on the name of Jesus, God, you're able to set us free. We thank you. We praise you again for the word. Thank you for our pastor. God, just continue to lift him up, touch him, not only physically, but, Lord, financially. We just continue to give you praise for all that is done. And all those that have heard this word, Lord, may you be encouraged on this week. course, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, if you want to be a giver to this great ministry, you can use Giblify. Also, if you just want to put a check in the mail, you can send it to 17401 Joseph Campau. Amen. There's some information. If you're not sure about Giblify, there's some information. If you just wait at the end of the message, that'll kind of explain the way to get on Giblify or use Giblify. Also, you can check out our Facebook as well as our website if you just wait and catch it on the end. Thank you.
Right on doing great things for me.